But then why have you always been so elusive as yourself?
Elusive?
You've always kept extremely elusive, haven't you? That's why that's how I felt when you became that chap in the outside world. I felt that's Alec Guinness himself somewhere.
No, I think there's probably always a little bit of me tucked into anything I play.
Yes.
You can't help it. Mm. Would like it not to be there, but it is bound to be.
But you never are like yourself in parts, as a matter of fact, I don't think. I think you become the person so effortlessly that it's quite puzzling.
I don't know. I think most actors are kind of chameleon-like characters. They react swiftly to an atmosphere or to another personality and absorb it fairly quickly.
Mm. But when you were young and you wanted to become an actor, why did people tell you not to become an actor so much? I got very cross for you in your autobiography.
I think people's views of actors is that they're always showing off, putting on funny voices, and being totally unreal. And I think if you see someone who's hopefully not doing those things, you think he can't be an actor. My experience of actors is absolutely the opposite, that they're perfectly, they may be very childish and very simple and ungrown up in lots of ways, but they're totally real people. And it's very few whom I know who wish to play themselves or show off themselves. Mm. I think most of us tuck away inside and don't want ourselves to be known, but whatever it is we're going to portray.
Mm. But I think that's why a lot of actors say they don't wish to be interviewed, because they don't want to be themselves. They don't feel as if they're going to be good enough without the lines.
Well, an interview becomes another performance which one hasn't rehearsed.
Well, that's it, and you would like to rehearse it word perfect, you mean?
Absolutely.
Yes. When you played in Dickens before, what is it that appeals to you about him as a writer?
I'm not sure that... I don't read much Dickens now. Mm. I used to. I played in a film, Great Expectations, and also Oliver Twist. I don't know, the vitality. And basically, I think it's Dickens's humor that appeals to me. And of course, as a writer, I think there are wonderful descriptive passages. Mm. I don't like his sentimental stuff at all. I mean, I can't run along with him there. Or indeed the melodrama. Mm. But on a comic line, or comic character, I think he's superb. Mm. No one to touch him.
Mm. Well, when you take on a part then, I mean, do you think you are a shy person coming forward to be somebody else? I mean, is that why you were so determined as a little boy to be an actor?
I don't know. I mean, those are all things for the psychoanalyst's couch, which I've never lain on and have no intention of laying. I don't want to know the springs of such talent as I have. Mm. I think people underestimate imagination in these things. And I think if you kind of play games, if you're a lonely child, or have been a lonely child, and you play games on your own, invent characters, invent things, it's only one step more to do that professionally.
Isn't it? Indeed. You know, when you wrote your autobiography, the very, very beginning of it, that was so like for me. I know I had to put the book down because it kind of overwhelmed me, your little bit about when you were a child left in a flat on your own, remember? I tell you why, though, because it was very like something from a Dickens. It was like Great Expectations or something.
Well, yes, indeed. I mean, he must have known a lot about what went on, and in his own very impoverished circumstances, I think he must have known what it was to be a small boy alone, and there is a similarity, and it's also, it seems to me, a very English sort of situation. That, at least if I think back to the, immediately after the 1418 war, there was an atmosphere that I can still think I can conjure up in my mind, and that's the atmosphere one lived in.
What do you mean exactly then?
Well, that it was, for me, glass was always slightly smoky. Shadows were very dark. There had been the Zeppelin raids. There was a, although there was a great rejoicing with peace, there was a sort of fear still for a child in the way one was living.
Mm. I mean, do you think that you've ever got rid of that fear? Because I think there are some parts of my childhood where I was frightened of the dark, which I've never overcome. It's just something that lives with me, and every now and again my heart pounds and my stomach drops.
I don't know whether one's got rid of it. I suppose, yes, I've got rid of the fear, but I can still well remember it and imagine it.
Because when you were left in the flat and you were in it, you felt very spooky, didn't you? You know?
Yeah.
And you went downstairs and found that funny old lady. Mm. And she was just like Miss Havisham to me.
Very much so. I mean, that's kind of just coincidental. I mean, it was, except that she was an old retired actress and a bit dotty and impoverished, presumably. But in a, I suppose in writing that book, I was trying to find points in my life which might have stimulated me to have a knowledge of the theatre as such. Mm. And I think she was one of them. I mean, she talked about the theatre, which I hadn't been to. And then another elderly lady in a hotel, again, took me to the Coliseum once to see a music hall show. They were all little kind of moments in my life which I've treasured and I'm very grateful for. Mm.